Hey guys, welcome to Warriors to Combatives. Now today we're looking more at the dynamic athleticism. So today I'm gonna show you an exercise with three associated exercises which must go with it in order to elicit the right training response. This is especially good for any fighter of who punches. If you're a Taekwondo guy, you might even still benefit from it, okay? But any martial artist, especially boxers, Thai boxers, kickboxers, and any wrestler, okay, are gonna greatly benefit from this. So realistically, everybody. Okay, the way it's gonna go, guys, is the first one that we're gonna work with, okay, is a variation of a glute bridge. We need to turn on our glutes and our hammy in order to make sure that we can properly move on to the next exercise in a functional manner. So the way that we're gonna do this, okay, so you take your weight, you'll put it on your hip, okay? From here, get up on the bench, all right? Put the dumbbell, okay, to start off with on one hip. The opposing hand, okay, is gonna grab the bench. From there, you need to pull on the bench so you turn your right lat on, okay? Bring your foot in, the one that has the dumbbell on it. The right knee is gonna point upwards to the sky. From here, I'm gonna drop the hip, okay, and I'm gonna turn that glute on and turn the hamstring on, digging my heel into the ground, all the way up, okay, exhale, and breathing back, and back up, good, back down, so you're thinking 3 seconds down, controlling the contraction, an explosive on the way up, okay? Ensure that you turn your lat on and your glute at the same time, okay? So you should feel the entire extension and pull of your lat as you drive that right knee up to the sky. And one more. Good. From here, we'll switch sides. Again, pulling with the left, okay? And driving that heel into the ground, okay? Glute turns on, hammy turns on, straight up. 3 seconds down, 1, 2, 3, exhale, rise up, good, back down, and more. Good. So that's turned on our glutes, it's turned on our hamstrings, and it's probably turned on our lower backs. Now the thing is, majority of us humans, we actually have this posterior pelvic tilt going on, and especially that we just did this, we might have actually aggravated it if we didn't turn it on properly. So what we need to do now is counterbalance our hip and bring this back into a neutral position, okay? How we're gonna do that, very simple, okay? But grab the bar shoulder width apart. Make sure that your fingers are properly interlaced on this thing. Now at the bottom, okay, one, you'll slightly depress your shoulder blades, okay? And you tuck your belly button in, and you're gonna raise your legs straight up. Touch the bar, with a toe to the bar, okay? You wanna do your best to lock your knees out and point your toes back. Again, press and pull. Good, 8 to 10 is good. So what that does, okay, putting those two in combination, is that one, you've turned on your glutes and your hamstrings, okay, and you've actually strengthened a very specific plane, okay, knees, kicks, whatever, anything you're driving off of the ground. But now, you've also turned on the entire, well, it's the front of the anterior chain, the psoas is on. It's kind of counterbalanced it. So what you did was actually put your pelvis back in place, okay, and turn the core on. So you're actually stable here. And you will feel it if you've never done this exercise before. And once you get that kinesthetic awareness, you will understand really what I'm saying. Now, you're gonna work with 4 sets of that, back and forth, 60 seconds rest in between. You can ramp up your weight, but don't ramp it so much that you're not doing it right. If you can feel the tissue turning on, properly and you can complete 8 to 10 reps, then it's okay, jump by 2 to 5 pounds. So now we'll work with the Swiss ball. The way this one's gonna work, guys, is you walk yourself out with that dumbbell on your chest, okay? So everything looks fine here. And same movement as what you did on the bench, boom, coming up. But now we have no back support, okay? Same movement that you did on the bar, in combination with it. You take that dumbbell, rack it way wide, shoulder width, okay, as far as you can. From here, turn the core and glutes on, turn the chest on, press straight up, okay? Back down, 3 seconds, 1, 2, 3, boom. Good, back down, 2, 3. Now, it may look like a chest exercise. This is absolutely not meant for the chest. This is pure core. You notice that my right hip has to fight to be stable so that it doesn't drop to the ground. My entire obliques and rib cage need to be in a neutral position. If they were shut off, the ball would fly behind me. I'd slam my head on the ground. Good. And I know I did that right because I can feel my entire right glute on fire. Okay, we'll switch off to the left side. And one, two, three, up. Seven more. So that one, ideally, it depends on how you're training. There's a lot of different styles that you could work with. Whether you're working strength range, hypertrophy range, which I don't suggest on that one. Power range, where you can be working a metabolic style, okay, of training. So it's the variables that make the difference between your training adaptations. Okay, so in combination with this, we're gonna work with the band. So we were working a lot of anti-rotation with the core there and with the pressing movement. Now what we are working is the acceleration, okay, of that strength. So how you'll set up is you'll grab that band, right? You walk yourself out from here. See if people can hear me. Find as much tension as you need. It shouldn't be to the point where you can't pull it properly. It should not be too difficult. You actually want to be able to accelerate. So one, push your hips back. Tuck your belly button in, okay? And all you'll do is you're gonna roll that elbow explosively into your hip. Okay? And what I mean by that is that the elbow stays low and the shoulder stays low. If you see the shoulder start to raise and the trap turn on, you're doing it incorrectly. So keep it low, pack your lat, turn the obliques, okay? Six is good on that. You want to maintain explosiveness and make sure that you're moving in the manner that you need to be moving for when you fight or for what your sport is specific to. One more time, walk back, hinge the hips, tuck your core, chest is up, and six. Just like that. Essentially, guys, those four exercises in conjunction, okay, in the manner that we just placed it, you're looking at least around 4 to 5 sets. Now, it is a superset, and you're thinking that you're splitting them in half. So you're going with number one and number two, okay, which was your single leg glute bridge paired, okay, with your toes to bar. And those, you're looking at 8 to 10. Realistically, always be increasing some of your rep range, your volume, or your intensity with the exercise in accordance to quality contractions. And quality contractions means that you're systematically turning on muscle group per muscle group, which creates a summation of the force, which will actually transfer to your sport specifics. Okay, so number one and number two, then number three and number four. Okay, that's really the bread and butter, what you're looking for, but they cannot be done until number one and number two have been done. So number three and number four, the way that I go about it is 5 rounds, 5 minutes each, and you're doing 5 to 6 reps per pull, 5 to 6 reps per press. I usually bring the weight up to 100 to 105 pounds per arm, okay? And you jack that and you do it as many times as you can in 5 minutes. And then you take 1 minute rest and you repeat that for about 25 minutes, okay? That's called metabolic power style. If you're looking for a strength base, then you're probably gonna jack up the weight even more and you're going up to 6 reps, but you're making sure your eccentric tempo is really slow, 3 to 4 seconds on the way down, okay? But you have to make sure you're maintaining quality technique. Your rest time is gonna be 120 seconds to 4 minutes is what you're looking for, so you can make sure the entire ATP and glycogen system is fully replenished, okay? If you're looking for a power range, then you're looking at 5 minutes rest and higher, but you're looking for 1 to 2 reps, make sure you have a spotter, because that stuff, if you fall and there's no one around, you're not a cat, you're a human, okay? And you might be an awesome martial artist, but there's 115 pounds possibly tacked to your arm, you might smash your face on something that you don't like, and who knows, maybe your girlfriend don't like you anymore, okay? So make sure you're safe, get a spotter. Guys, we'll see you next time.